basically, we've been involved in commemorating the start of World War One, and we particularly want to do activities that are relevant for young people. And when you begin to look at sport and the contribution of sportsmen and women from Guernsey and beyond to World War One, and they're no different to any other sector of the community. But there's so many interesting stories that we thought that it would be something that young people could relate to. So we decided that on the middle of December, we chose December 14th as our date because in England they have a Football Remembers campaign, which is to do with the truce that took place on Christmas Day and the football matches. But we broadened ours out to cover all sports because Guernsey plays so many sports.
I'm going to be helping run a five-a-side tournament. It's basically for year sixes. It's going to be two groups of four. The winner gets a little prize at the end of it.
In particular, I'm happy to commemorate Percy Hodge, who was an athlete who went to fight in World War One, and then in 1920 won the Olympic Games for steeplechase, and also all the other athletes from different sports such as football and rugby that fought in World War One.
We're commemorating the endurance athletes who fought in World War One, and it's good to honour them.
So we've got a commemoration that day, and it isn't going to be like a normal commemoration service. We want people to turn up in their sports kit. There's going to be lots of different things going on during the actual the service. We're going to have two sports activities going on. Then we've got tug of war, and we're going to have our Percy Hodge Memorial Mile, where we're going to see how many of our athletes can run the time that Percy Hodge ran in 1912, which was 4:52. So it's going to be a bit different. We've got a choir being formed for the day. The Help for Heroes Choir will have their debut, in fact, their one and only performance on the day. And that's going to be songs associated with sport, but also associated with World War One. And for example, we're going to be singing Waltzing Matilda because we want to recognise the contribution that the people from the Commonwealth played in sportsmen and women in the war. So it's really just something that we think will engage young people in a way that perhaps other events won't be able to.
Obviously it's good to remember that back in the day they were still playing sport and football's still a big thing, so.
Take part in this event because I think although it is commemorated with things like Remembrance Day, sports players that lost their lives often don't get remembered enough. I mean, Alan before was just telling us about England, New Zealand, all their captains dying. And although often they did die as teams, although it's not really a consolation, but it's good to know they died doing what they loved with who they love. So I think it's important to remember them because they just don't get enough.
It's a great laugh, I think, at the end of the day, and show your face, show that you can give something back to the community as well, and if there's donations to be handed out, do your part.
I'm involved in the Percy Hodge Memorial Mile, which is basically us trying to beat Percy Hodge's time of 4:52.
There's a football five-a-side competition and rugby sevens competition. There'll be a women's rugby match as well, and also tug of war going on.
It's definitely an important event, and I'm really, really glad to be part of it and getting involved. It's good.
Yeah, well, it's exciting, obviously, to finally have an event which commemorates World War One like this, and hopefully it'll be good fun and everyone will come down and take part.
I think it's really good for us to remember the people who fought in World War One and for us to continue that forwards in the future, help commemorate.
Come down, enjoy yourself, do your best, try your best, but also still remember what we're down here for on the day.